Hey, how you doing? I'm Professor Corder. What are we gonna do? We are going to do the introductory lab water experiment. I printed part of the lab for myself so that I can read it, but you know, it's on and in module one, so you can just open it up and take a look at it there. I'm gonna read the first part on page four. Yeah, page four. It says, introduction exercise two. Let me read some of this to you. Quality water is colorless, tasteless, and odorless. Odd colors, tastes, and smells are impurities in the water, which does not necessarily mean these things are dangerous. No, they just aren't water. To complete the following exercise, you must observe an experiment conducted by me, your instructor, on the linked video, which you're watching right now, with water from two particular sources. One of the samples is store-bought bottled water. There you go, Aquafina. You've probably heard of Aquafina before. It doesn't matter whether it's Aquafina or Fiji or Kirkland. I don't care what it is, okay? But this is bottled water, all right? The other is from a source at the Santa Ana College campus, the ornamental fountain located near the administration building. There's the ornamental fountain right there. That's what it looks like. Now, if you happen to be at Santa Ana College from time to time, you can go out and look at it. What did I do? I took one of these beakers, I went outside, I dipped it into the ornamental fountain, and we're going to test it. The idea here is, what are your expectations for bottled water when you buy it versus an ornamental fountain or a swimming pool? I would have different expectations. I don't know about you, but I would have different expectations. So this experiment uses two 500 milliliter beakers of water, and they're labeled A and B. This one is A, this one is B. I'm not telling you which one is Aquafina and which one is from the ornamental fountain, but there is A and B and we're going to test them. Beginning with beaker A, following the instructions described in part one, testing pH, your instructor, which is me, will test both samples of water, beaker A first, then beaker B, which you will then need to observe on the YouTube video attached to this module. And the video is entitled, or the page is entitled, Introduction Exercise to Water Experiment. I wrote it, I should be able to say that, but I can't really say it. After completing the experiment described below in part one, pH, I will then move to part two, chlorine, and so on. Okay, that's where we're gonna do it. So if you look down at the bottom, you can see, or you know, on your computer screen, you can see that it says part one, pH. Let's start with that. I have a flickering light here. It's not trying to be a strobe cool thing like we're in a club. It's just, I have a flickering light. It's stupid, but that's what's going on. So part one says this, testing pH. Using one of the plastic bags with the yellow twister at the top. There's the plastic bag with the yellow twister at the top. Okay, there you go. Using one of those, pour in water from the beaker labeled A. So this is sample A right there. So what I'm going to do and what I've already done is pour water in there. Where? Up to line C. If you look, you can see line C. See line C? It's right there. Okay, so I poured water into a bag up to line C, all right? Then remove one of the pH wide range tablets with scissors and drop it into the plastic bag. Well, this is what these little containers look like. Inside there are these little pills. You drop them in there. I'm wearing these because I don't want to have the reaction or some kind of weird reaction from touching these pills. But this is what they look like. I already did it all, so you don't have to do any of that. Hold the bag up and shake it gently until the tablet has dissolved. Compare the color of the reaction of the bag to the pH section of the tap water color chart. So then we do the same thing with B, all right? Going on to page six, it's page six. And you can see that for pH, there are five questions, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So let's start with this. Number one, on page six, what is the pH of your samples? And are they acidic, basic, or neutral? Well, this is sample A. In other words, it came from that beaker right there. We don't know whether this is Aquafina or whether this is the ornamental fountain. I'm gonna hold it up to here and you're just going to compare the color. Does that sample A look like 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Does it look like any of those? Let's try it again. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. See how that rhymes? How about that? All right. So record whichever one it is. Okay. Go ahead and do that for sample A. Then sample B. Let's do the same thing. Here's sample B. You can see it looks different, doesn't it? Does it look like 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11? Again, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Which one does it look most like? Record that there and then look back at page 3 and determine whether these samples are, like, whether A is acidic, neutral, or basic. Okay, go ahead and do that. And then look at, I'm just reading here, look at the pH in figures 1 and 2 on page 3 of this lab. What substance or substances does or do your samples correspond with? In other words, does sample A correspond with milk or with eggs or with bleach, or what does it correspond to? Okay, and write that down there. Now let's go to number 3. Gently open the plastic bag for sample A. Take one of the straws, this is a reusable straw, take one of the straws, blow into the sample for about 60 seconds. Okay, so let's do this. Here's sample A again, and we will be able to do this right here. Let's see what happens to the color of the water if I can get this thing open. Of course I can't get it open because I'm under the gun right now. Here we go, put this in here, and you can see up against my lovely white lab coat. Here we go, I'm gonna blow into this. I don't want to suck in because I don't want to drink this up. Pretty good. Look at that. Did it change colors? Sure did. Now, what is this new pH? What is the new pH? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. All right, it's one of those. Which one is it? We get rid of that one temporarily. All right, very good. Now let's do it with B. So here's B, see if I can get B open. The clock is ticking, you can hear the clock ticking. Tick, 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 tock, 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 tick, 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 tock. Here we go, putting this in. There's the straw. I'm gonna blow again on it. Wow, I think I survived it. So what happened? Did the color change? Indeed it did. Where is sample B now? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Again, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Which one is it at? Huh? Which one? There you go. Good. Excellent job there. So record that. So what is the new pH? Of course, what happened to the color of the water? And why did it change? Well, as I'm exhaling, is it because I have the breath of a dragon? Of course, that's not what it is. I'm exhaling carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is an acid. So I'm adding acid to the water. And what is that doing to the color of the water? And what is it doing to the pH? That's the question. All right, let's go to part 2, the bottom of page 6. Part 2, testing chlorine. We do the same thing. We fill the bag up to whatever it is, line C, that's what it says. We put it in one of these DPD4 rapid tablets, then we roll it down and we do the same thing. We shake it around. So let's see what it is for chlorine. Okay, there's chlorine right there in the middle. This is sample A. Take a look at chlorine. Sample A, low chlorine, high chlorine. Low chlorine, high chlorine. Low chlorine, high chlorine. Could be a song. Low chlorine, high chlorine. Which chlorine is it? That's sample A. Let's look at sample B. Sample B, low chlorine. Look, come on, let's face it. There's zero. There's no chlorine in this one at all. Zero. No chlorine in sample B. Chlorine, zippo, nothing. Very good. Record that. All right, let's go to page 7. So page 7, testing copper. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to do the same thing we did before. Here is sample A for copper. Okay, I want you to record this once we see it. There's copper. The first one is no copper. Second one may taste bitter and stain because there's some copper. Third one will taste bitter and will stain because there's a lot of copper. Which one is it? No copper, may taste bitter and stain, so there's a little copper, or really, really coppery. Okay, that's A. You want to see something crazy? Watch this one for B. Same thing. B, no copper, may taste bitter, a lot of copper. Which one does it most match up with? All right. Of the three possibilities, which one for A and B? Copper stains porcelain. Things like toilets, sinks, and bathtubs. A greenish blue or bluish greenish color, sorry. Are these samples likely to cause stains? The two that we just saw for A and for B. All right. Now we're going to part four, testing hardness. Hard water is water that has a lot of calcium and or magnesium dissolved in it. It's pretty typical for Southern California water that we have kind of a lot of that in it. The white crusty spots and scales on shower heads, around a bathtub, around drains, or on drinking glasses are the result of hard water deposits. So we're gonna fill the bags up, put the hardness tab in, or the one of these tablets, you put it in, shake it around, and then we get some new colors. Let's see what they are. So this is for sample A. There's the hardness scale. Is sample A soft water or hard water? Soft water or hard water? Soft water or hard water? All right, record that. Sample B, here we go, watch this. Oh boy, is it ever different. Soft water, hard water. Soft water, hard water. Remember, you're looking at this and you're trying to figure out which one of these is the Aguafina, which one is coming from that ornamental fountain. Soft water, hard water. All right, record it. Very good. And now we go to testing iron. Fill the bag to line C with your sample, put it in, iron thing, so on. And here we go. So, number one, sample A, iron. Can you already see what's happening here? What do you see that with iron? Personally, I see pretty much nothing. I probably shouldn't tell you that, but I see zero. Nothing for sample A. See what sample B's like. Is it gonna change anything? It did not, which means neither of these sources have iron in them. Not even low iron. Forget about high iron, Zippo iron, okay? Very good. Then part six says this. Your sample, which sample do you believe is the bottled water? Based on your expectations for bottled water, what causes you to come to that kind of conclusion? All right. Hope you enjoyed this. I had a great time making this. One of my favorite things, maybe in my entire lifetime, was making this video for you. All right, so make sure you have everything recorded. And now, if you do, and you did the first part of this introductory lab, you are ready to take the lab quiz. Let's go.